These days, it's more common to find people building high-performance, high-powered turbocharged engines, so high-revving, naturally aspirated V8s are becoming more and more rare. However, Georg Plasa's E36 BMW hillclimb car behind me is probably one of the most recognisable in the European hillclimb championship, and I know I've personally lost hours watching, or more specifically, listening to this thing on YouTube videos. The engine in the car is a 3.4-litre Judd V8, that is actually originally designed for LMP2 Le Mans endurance racing. Now, in this guise, it produces around about 560 horsepower at 10,200 RPM. It revs all the way to 10,750 where it'll hit the soft cut, and the full hard cut rev limiter is at an insane 11,200 RPM. And that high RPM is really what gives this car the distinctive sound, sounding much like a Formula One car going up the European hill climbs. Now, these days, 560 horsepower really isn't a huge amount, and some of the cars that this car has competed against and beaten will be turbocharged engines producing upwards of 700 or 800 horsepower. Of course, power isn't everything, and it all comes down to power and weight. And when this car was originally developed by Georg, the design was around keeping the weight to the absolute minimum. In this case, the car weighs only 895 kgs, and for anyone who has tried to pull weight out of a road-going car, this is no mean feat, particularly when the car still has a full chassis, as well as a multi-point roll cage to keep the driver safe. As well as the 560 horsepower and 895 kgs, another thing working in this car's favour is the downforce, or the aerodynamic package. Now, this really looks like something pulled straight out of the DTM series. There is a lot of work that has gone into producing an aerodynamic package on the car to produce as much downforce as possible. And these cars in hill climb format will run up to about 211 mile an hour, depending on the specific gearing that is used. That gearing will be changed depending on the specific hill climb the car is competing in. Backing up the engine is a Hewlin 6-speed transmission. Now, when the car was first built, this was a relatively run-of-the-mill H-pattern dog engagement gearbox. There wasn't a lot of electronic trickery or intervention used for the gear shifting. As the car was developed, it was first of all switched across to sequential gear shifting, and then finally, in the guise behind me, the car is now paddle shifted. This means that the driver can stay at full throttle during the upshift, and the Motec M800 ECU will use an ignition cut to allow the dogs to disengage in the gearbox and the next gear to be engaged. On the downshift, despite the fact that this car does use a cable throttle, a little dated by today's standards, but obviously the norm back when this car was developed, a auto blip for the downshift is able to be introduced by the ECU, meaning that once the car leaves the start line, the driver doesn't need to use the clutch. Now, talking about that Motec M800 ECU, of course, as we've just discussed, that's in charge of the gear shift control as well as that Judd V8 engine. However, there are some other functions that the team are using to give themselves as much advantage as possible. In particular, an advanced launch control strategy and traction control are both employed through that Motec M800 ECU. The other driver aid that is relied on heavily is the Continental ABS system, and this is adjustable by the driver to suit the conditions that the car is competing in. This may allow the driver to use more or ABS intervention depending on whether the road or track is dry or potentially wet with low traction. Backing up the Motec M800 ECU is a Cosworth driver display, which also acts as a central logging hub. And with the competitive nature of the European Hill Climb Championship, this is essential for the data engineer to be able to download data after a run up a specific event's hill climb and look at ways to improve both the engine performance, the chassis performance, as well as potentially any areas where the driver could improve and hold more speed. While the E36 chassis is definitely getting a little dated by today's standards, with 560 horsepower and only 895 kgs, plus such a well-sorted chassis in general, this car is still able to hold its own. And just a few weeks ago, in testing for the 2019 Goodwood Festival of Speed, the car managed to set a new course record at a local hill climb during practice. Personally, I'm just glad that someone's still racing a high-revving, naturally aspirated V8 among that sea of turbocharged engines.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.